Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel, the Soren Seward Family. I'm Ivy. Thank you for joining me for another Friday mommy moment with me. And wait right there, you do not have to be a mommy to enjoy this moment. All you need is a moment. If it's your first time here, go ahead and smash that subscribe button, ring that notification bell so you can be notified whenever we upload a video. And if you're one of our absolutely famously great, 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 great returning subscribers, welcome. Go ahead and grab your beverage, your coffee, because you already know what we about to do. But first, we about to get into these Friday shoutouts. Let's go. Today, I have two shout outs that I want to give out, you guys. And the first shout out is going to TaylorMade TV and Sheila Lanes, because those are the same people. I'm going to drop her link below so you can know who she is. Sheila is somebody who I met on YouTube, you guys, and who knew that God would turn it into what it is right now. I consider her a very dear, close sister to me. I love you so much, and that's all I'm gonna say about that. This shout out is going out to you, sis. I love you. The second shout out is going to Yolanda. Now, I do not know how to pronounce your last name, so I'm not even gonna try, but I am gonna throw you up here on the screen so people can see who you are. She has been so loyal. She has been supporting this channel. And you guys, we recently connected on Instagram. If you're not connected with me on Instagram, go ahead and find us on Instagram at the Soren Seward Family. Yolanda, you are so awesome. Thank you for coming into that live and praying over everybody that was in there. And we was just in there and we was believing for God to do some great things, and I'm so glad that we are connected, sis. I look forward to going into the year 2020 with you. All right, you guys, that's all the shout outs that I have for today. Go ahead, grab your beverage, grab your snacks, whatever it is, because we about to jump right into this topic, okay? Yeah, because I know y'all trying to get back to them leftovers from Thanksgiving. I am too. First, you guys, I want to say that if you are struggling with keeping negativity out of your space, I'm right there along with you. So often, so many times, when people put us down, when people are so negative to us, we do shake it off, but it still seems to like stay right in our storage space that we have in our mind. And I wanna clear that out, because sometimes if we hear it too much, it becomes our reality. And what I mean by that is, check this out. When I was growing up, I heard the word stupid used towards me all the time. I was called stupid so many times, I can't even count. So many times. And it might sound crazy, like, what do you mean? People just called you stupid. Yes, that's exactly what I mean. If I did make a mistake, it was like, ah, you're so stupid. Why would you do that? Oh, you're so stupid. Why would you drop that? You know, you can't see that. You that stupid. And that's what I took on to be that I was. And me having trouble that I did in school, which would be, I believe I'm gonna talk about that next week. So y'all tune in next week for that. I started to believe it even more. I was 23 years old when I met my husband. And if I got something wrong, every time I spoke, I would say, oh yeah, I know I'm stupid, my bad. And he'd be like, hey, stop talking about my friend like that. Every time I did something, every time I made a mistake from the time I had inherited that I was stupid, I called myself stupid. All the time. Now you just imagine how many times you have dropped something, you have tripped, or you put something on backwards, or all the little things, and I would call myself stupid, even out loud. But every time I did it around my best friend at the time, who's still my best friend, but he just ended up marrying me, he would say, hey, don't talk about my best friend like that. Hey, stop talking about my friend like that. I didn't realize how much I called myself stupid. Not only did I not realize how much I called myself stupid, I didn't realize that I really believed that I was stupid. I really thought that I was stupid. I had took that label, that word that others called me, and I had made it my own. I had embraced that. Sounds weird, but that was my reality. Even to this day, I'm now 37. I have to catch myself from saying it. Now, do I believe that I'm stupid? No, I don't believe that I'm stupid, but I did. But the words of other people can affect us and we not even realize it. We can start becoming that piece of crap that people call us, you know? Or we make a mistake and all of a sudden we're a failure. so we can start to carry that. We will make mistakes and we will do things wrong. And people will like, oh, you're a loser. You hear that so many times, you start to believe that you're really a loser. Somebody keeps calling you ugly and you hear from more than one person and you're just like, okay, wait a minute. Am I ugly? Do I really not look good? Okay, I know I gained a little weight, but am I like, you know, unattractive? I know that my skin isn't like other people. Is everybody staring at me? And you start to own these things. You start to own all this, what the world is labeling you as. And I want to let you know that I don't want you to label yourself nothing but a child of God. A child of God. Everybody looks different. Everybody's path is different. Nobody is the same. But do not take the labels of the world and put them on your heart and call it a done deal. The world might call that you and they might want you to live that up and be just that. But no, you are great. You are beyond that. And even where you are right now, you will continue to rise because you are a child of God. You are not who they say you are. We need to be careful what we allow to be put into us and what we allow to believe us to be. When we start doing that, depression sits in, anxiety sits in, and we start to lose ourselves. But I wanted to come today and remind you that you are a child of God. You are special. You are not that mistake. You are not a loser. You are not stupid. You are beautiful. You are handsome. You have been created with greatness by the Maker himself. And I want you to know that, and I want you to believe that. I don't care what type of skin you have, what body you're in, what type of hair you have, how much education you have, how many times you slipped. All I care about is who you are now and that you're getting back up from that little slope that you slipped into. And you're taking all that negativity that people are throwing on you and you're saying, I'm tired of this. I don't want to hear it no more. That is not who I am. And when you think that is who you are and it comes from out of that storage, I want you to get it out of there because that's not who you are. And I felt that in my heart to share today because I've been going through some stuff myself. And I love to come and share with you because, hey, if I'm going through it, some other people might be going through it too. But I came to tell you that I had somebody like a Sheila pour into my life, pour into me, and let me know who I am and who God created me to be. And I'm still a child of God. And what they say don't matter. Because you know what? If God is for me, who can be against me? Who can be against you? Nobody. So that's all I have for you today, you guys. Stay blessed, stay true, and continue to be you because the world needs more people like you. And if you're not feeling needed, please know that whenever you click on this channel, we want you to know that you are needed. Peace out.